Hey, here's a problem that requires the use of the steam tables to keep track of the volume of a container of, I guess it's initially mainly of liquid water. We can take some of our given information here, and we're told that we have a system that contains 0.49 meters cubed of liquid water that's in equilibrium with 0.01 meters cubed of water vapor to make up the balance of the tank. And we want to see what happens when we heat this system up to 140 degrees C. We'll start by looking at some of our initial conditions here. We know that when we're at 25 degrees C, we have vapor-liquid equilibrium. It was given in the problem statement. We have both vapor and liquid present, and therefore we can use the saturated steam tables to look up any property that we want. In this case, we're working with volume. We're told the total volume of the drum that we're working with. And so we can look up, for example, the volume of the liquid phase component, and that's equal to 0.001003 meters cubed per kilogram. Now, what this then allows us to do is to compute the mass of liquid water that's in our tank, and that's equal to 0.49 meters cubed divided by this volume of the liquid that we just wrote out, which tells us that we have 488.5 approximately kilograms in the liquid phase. Now we also have some water vapor that is in our system that occupies 0.01 meters cubed, but the volume of that vapor is several orders of magnitude lower than the volume of the liquid on a per kilogram basis. And so it turns out that this is going to add hardly any amount to our mass. And you can go in and go through and do that calculation using the volume of the vapor and the 0.01 meters cubed to see that for yourself. But we'll just take that as a given for the rest of the problem that the vapor really isn't going to contribute much mass at all, and so we'll just neglect it. Now we want to see what happens at 140 degrees C. As we increase this temperature, one thing that we can look at is what will the state of the system be? Will we have vapor, liquid, or some kind of vapor-liquid equilibrium situation still persisting? So the way that we can look at this is to look at the volume of the liquid at 140 degrees C, and we see that it's equal to 0.00108 meters cubed per kilogram. Okay, so it's gone up by a significant percentage, but a very small amount in terms of the meters cubed per kilogram. So one thing that we can do is we can ask the question whether all of the water that was initially in the system ended up becoming liquid as we heated up to 140 degrees C. And so let's just test this. And so if that happened, then we could take that 488.5 kilograms and multiply it by the volume of the liquid, which is given up here as the 0.00108 meters cubed per kilogram. And if that were the case, then we would have a volume occupied by the liquid of 0.5276 meters cubed, which is greater than the volume of the container of 0.5 meters cubed. Right, and so this means that even if we condense all of the water to the more dense phase, which is the liquid, at 140 degrees C, the space between water molecules and the liquid has grown to such an amount that it will occupy more than the volume of the original container if we have a pure saturated liquid. If we formed any vapor which is less dense, then it would occupy even more volume than this 0.5276. And so we know that what we therefore would form in this system is a compressed liquid. Right? So it's a liquid that is compressed from its saturated state. Right? It's at a higher pressure than the saturated liquid, which would be potentially in equilibrium with the vapor. We see that this compression would have to be pretty significant, that liquids are largely incompressible. And here we're looking at something like a 4% required compression from saturated liquid water to the compressed state. And so this would require a very large pressure in order to do this compression. And if the drum that the liquid water was in was not sufficiently rated to a high enough pressure, then the tank would potentially rupture. Okay, we can explore a little bit using the steam tables. In the back of most textbooks, you'll see that there are some compressed liquid steam tables. We can look up a data point. So at 140 degrees C at a very high pressure, the highest in the steam tables I have with me, of 100 megapascals, or about 1,000 atmospheres, then the volume of the liquid is equal to 0.001028 meters cubed per kilogram. Okay, we could assume if we were at that condition that all of the, it would be compressed liquid, and so all of the mass would be in the liquid phase, and so we have 0.5 meters cubed divided by 488.5 kilograms. What the actual density of the liquid water would have to be in order for that initial mass to occupy only half a meter cubed would be 0.001024 meters cubed per kilogram. And this volume per mass is still less than the volume per mass at 100 megapascals, and so we'd have to increase the pressure to greater than 100 megapascals in order to get that high of a density of liquid water. And so we know that the pressure would have to go above 100 megapascals, or about 1,000 atmospheres, in order to keep the liquid water inside this container. And so if the container is not strong enough to withstand a pressure of 100 megapascals, which may not be very likely, then we would expect that we would have a possible rupture of the container and therefore a safety situation.